assistant professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Instrumentation and Control. Today's our topic is relative gain array in the unit number 5, Introduction to Multivariable System. In the last session, we will study about what is the relative gain array. So it's provide two important things, a measure of process interaction and recommendation of the most effective pairing of M and Y. So using the relative gain array, we can find out the most effective pair of this multi-loop control system. Okay, but if there is a problem using the relative gain array, that time we can use the extension of the relative gain array using to find the most effective pairing of M and Y. Today's our topic is singular value analysis that we have studied in the last session. What is the singular value analysis? It is the better than RGA if there is a problem arising using the relative gain array to find out the best pairing. That time we can use the singular value analysis. It reveals some fact that are not revealed by RGA, and it is used the selection of the control measure and the manipulator variable, in evaluation of the robustness of the proposed control strategy, and the most important thing is in determination of the best multi-loop control configuration. So let's take one example for the singular value analysis. So for a process model, as you know, Y is my output signal and U is my input signal. So the equation will become Y is equal to KU, where K is our steady state gain matrix. Now, K must be such that the N linear equation in N unknown be linearly independent. So for that, if equations are dependent, then not all of the N control variable can be independently regulated. So for that, we can use the singular value analysis. If determinant of the K is zero, the matrix is singular and the N equation are not linearly independent. But another way to check for the linear independence by using the eigenvalues, K minus lambda I, that is equal to 0, or alpha I minus K, that is equal to 0. So the two things that we have to check if determinant of the K is 0. What is K? It is the steady state gain. So that type of matrix is singular and the N equation are not linearly independent. And the another way to check for linear independence is we have to find the eigenvalue using this equation. Mod of K minus alpha I, that is equal to 0. Okay, so if in eigenvalue is 0, K is singular, that is the fixed position. If K is non-singular, that is the second condition, so we have to find the value of Cn. Cn, that is equal to delta max upon delta mean. Delta max is equal to largest non-zero singular value and it is the smallest non-zero singular value, and we have to try that Cn must be small. So if K is singular, then Cn is infinity and it's not possible, because if eigenvalue is zero, K is singular, and K is singular, that means we can get the value of Cn is infinity, and it is not possible for all MIMO system. So for more understanding, we have to take one example. Here the value of K, steady state gain, K is given in the matrix form 1, 0, 10, 1. Okay, now we have to find the RGA. What is the equation of RGA? RGA is equal to lambda 1, 1, that is equal to 1 upon 1 minus K1, 2, K2, 1, K1, 1, K2, 2. So put the value of this 1 upon 1 minus 0, we can get the answer 0. So the RGA we can get 1, 0, and 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. So we can get 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, now according to the RGA, it is the best possible MIMO with 1122 configuration, because here the answer of the RG is 1001. So it is the base suitable pair of the MIMO system, and the configuration is 1122. As you remember, in the MIMO system example or MIMO system lecture, we can see the two configuration for the two input and the two output, U1, U2, Y1, Y2. The first configuration is U1 with Y1 and U2 with Y2. That is 1122 configuration. And the second configuration is if U1 input with Y2 output and U2 input with the Y1 output, we can get the pairing 1221 configuration. So if the value of the RGA like this form, it is the base suitable configuration of 1122 configuration. But if we find the value of SVA for the same steady state value, so the equation of the SVA, that is equal to K transformed into K. Okay, so we can take the transform of K. So that is equal to 1 10 0 1 1 0 10 1. So if we have to multiply these two matrix, we can get A is equal to 1 0 1 10 10 and 1. Okay, now as you remember, if we have to find the value of SVA, we have two method. The first one is we have to check this, it is singular or not, and the second is we have to find the eigenvalue of this particular system. So the equation is lambda I minus A. A that we have to find using the equation K transformed into K, and lambda is given. I matrix is 1 0 0 1, so we have to multiply the I matrix with the lambda, we can get lambda 0 0 lambda. Minus A matrix is 1 0 1 10 10 and 1, that is equal to 0. Okay, now we have to find out the value of lambda. So lambda minus 1 0 1 and 0 minus 10, okay, and up n, 0 minus 10, that is cancel out, and lambda minus 1, and minus 10 into minus 10, that is equal to minus 100. So lambda minus 101, lambda minus 1, minus 100, that is equal to 0. Now you have to simplify this equation, we can get lambda square minus lambda minus 101 lambda plus 101 minus 100, that is equal to 0. Here the constant term is 100, not 101. Okay, so if we simplify this equation, we can get lambda 1 is equal to 10.09 and lambda 2 is equal to 0.098. How we have to simplify this equation? So lambda square minus lambda minus 101 lambda plus 101 minus 100, that is equal to 0. You have to use the formula V square minus 4AC. Okay, and you have to find the value of lambda 1 and lambda 2. Now in the singular value analysis, you have to find the CN. Okay, and what is the equation of CN? Maximum, largest non-zero singular value, and the smallest non-zero singular value, and the condition is CN must be small. So we have to take the CN, the largest value is 10.09 and smallest value is 0.098 according to our example. So put the value of lambda 1 and lambda 2 in the equation of CN, we can get 10.09 upon 0.098. That is equal to 101.922. Now here you can see that the value of CN is more than 100. That means CN is very large. It means it is very sensitive to slight variation is K. So now next target is we have to slightly change the value of steady state gain K, and then we have to check the value of CN. Okay, so for that, here K matrix is given 1 0 10 and 1. We have to slightly change the value of steady state gain K. So now new value of K Here simply we can change 0 with 0.1. So 1, 0.1, 10 and 1. A small variation in k. Okay, so we can get lambda that is equal to 1 upon 1 minus 0.1 into 10 upon 1 into 1. That is equal to infinite. Okay, so if we can get the value of lambda infinite, RGA does not exist. And so for that, we have to find the value of k minus lambda I using the SVA technique. Okay, so put the value of k minus lambda I, that is equal to 0, and we can get the two value of alpha or the lambda. So the matrix is 1 minus alpha 0.1, 10 minus 1 minus alpha, that is equal to 0. So 1 minus alpha whole square minus 1, that is equal to 0. So 1 minus 2 alpha plus alpha square minus 1, that is equal to 0. So alpha in the bracket alpha minus 2 is equal to 0. So we can get alpha is equal to 0 and alpha is equal to 2. Okay, now we have to find the eigen value. So here 1 eigen value is 0. So mod of k, that is equal to 1.1 10 1. We have to find the mod of k, that we can get the 0. So k becomes singular. So k is singular. That means it becomes impossible to control by the manipulated variable. Okay. So how we can change the value of singular value using the SVA, and we have to change the steady state value, tightly change, and then we have to find the value of k. Okay. In the above case, there is a not possible way to find the value of k if we can change the value of steady state gain from 0 to 0.1, we can get k is a singular, but it is impossible to find the manipulated variable. So using the MATLAB software, you can continuously check the value of steady state gain, input variable, output variable, control variable and manipulated variable. You can check the pairing of the system and you have to find the best solution for this particular control system using the MATLAB software. Okay. Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt regarding this topic, you have to contact me in my email ID.